So this week, Reverend Mbaka had a message for Mr. President.
Hunger everywhere. As the president is fighting corruption, some of us are praying that he will equally fight hunger.
Snap!
The landlords are crying. Tenants are lamenting. There is hunger on the streets. Many students are being rusticated out of the school because they can't pay for school fees. Many companies are winding up.
Preach, my brother, preach!
The president should please look around himself and those who are telling him that there's no trouble. The president should know that there's trouble. And if things continue like this, in the next election, nobody will vote for him.
Tell them, I beg it, tell them. Yes, so Oga Buhari, people are hungry. What I don't understand is how Mr. President is sleeping at night when people are dying of hunger. And it's not just people living in Nigeria. This thing is affecting Nigerians all over the world. I get emails from Nigerian international students in different parts of the world. Adam Dixon is one of 200 Nigerian students abandoning various universities across Europe and Canada. He wrote me because they were awarded scholarship by the Niger Delta Development Commission, that is NDDC. Imagine not being paid your living allowances for 8 months. How do they think the students are eating? Others could not even register for classes. The school is pushing them out and they have nobody abroad. The same thing is happening among Kano students who won government scholarship to study in India, Egypt, Sudan, China, Turkey, Cyprus. They didn't pay their tuition, their accommodation or living allowances for 10 months. The school threatened to stop them from writing exams. The last thing that I heard from the Kano students abroad is that the government has approved the payment of 3 months allowances. But what about their tuition and flight ticket? So many parents can no longer afford sending their children abroad to study because the same amount that they used to pay for tuition last year doesn't even add up to half right now. As a result, several Nigerian international students have returned home or moved to Ghana to continue their education. Imagine that you started in America, ended in Ghana, started in America, ended in Nigeria. And so many other students are stranded abroad trying to find a way by all means. Some of them are now walking off campus, which is illegal, which means they could be arrested and they could be deported. And let me just say this, for those that have never traveled outside Nigeria, some of them think that living abroad is like living in heaven. No, 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 please. International students suffer abroad. Please, don't let anybody deceive you because some of them would write comments like, oh, well, you're already in America. What else do you need? No. How much is dollars to naira now? 400. Chai, 400 naira to $1, my people. Which is why I don't understand why Mr. President is subsidizing forex for pilgrims. The central bank has directed banks and forex sellers to sell dollars to pilgrims for 197 naira to a dollar. And this applies not only to Muslim pilgrims going on Hajj, because last year he did the same thing for Christians that went to Jerusalem for their traveling allowance. You cannot tell Nigerians that religion is not important, so we are not even going to debate that. Yes, religion is important, but education is also very important. This is something that will shape the future of these students. Mr. President, why can't you show them the same courtesy you're showing those that are going on pilgrimage? Pilgrims will go, they will come back. Students are trying to invest in their lives. They are trying to invest in their future, and you cannot do this for them, Mr. President. I don't understand. All you need is evidence that they are enrolled, which is very easy. Who is advising this man? And it's not just that international students that are suffering. For those who have families that are going through tough times in Nigeria, it's now very difficult to send money to Nigeria. A viewer by the name Ewade Love was the one that alerted me that the central bank in Nigeria has blocked several global remittance companies from transferring money to Nigeria. The only ones that they didn't block is Western Union, MoneyGram and RIA. Maybe transfers is still working, I don't know. But now it's very difficult to send money to Nigeria. Buhari needs to wake up and do something fast. He can start by listening to my episode on how America came out of recession. There's a lot of robbery going on now in restaurants across Nigeria. People are stealing food, and there has been several cases of people selling food on the streets being robbed. As Father Mbaka said, there is hunger everywhere. And please, if this doesn't affect you, if you're doing well where you are, that doesn't mean that it's not happening to some people. By the way, Mr. President, how do you want us to believe you're fighting corruption when the Speaker of the House, Dogara, is boasting about padding the budget?
I studied law. I've been a legislator. All this period, I've never had the word padding being an offense under any law.
No, this cannot be happening. Is this true? To all the lawyers that are watching me, isn't padding the same thing as indirectly stealing money?
Are you worried?
I wouldn't know. Worried? Why should I be worried? As far as I'm concerned, I'm not worried about it.
Oh my God, this is an insult on Nigerians as a whole. Last year, stealing is not corruption. Now, padding the budget is not an offense. These people padded the Nigerian budget by 480 something billion naira. As of last week, that's more than $1.5 billion. And he's talking as if it's nothing. And you know what's pissing me off? The fact that he said these things right after meeting with Buhari. Mr. President, this is how you're fighting corruption? What did you tell him? that made him to come out that bold to tell us he's not worried? I thought he would be afraid after meeting with Buhari. The way he stands right now, all these big people, when they're still in Nigeria, they know nothing would happen to them. That's what we are seeing. But you guys don't know much. Guess what? I'm just keeping it real.